of this lucha, we learned one of my famous unique opportunities. Introducing first, from the cosmos, Aerostar!
Well, as we've come to know these two luchadores, we've seen everything they have. Aerostar and Drago started with the mutual respect. Then the tensions began to boil over. There you see Aerostar in the pure white. Perhaps that means something. This unique opportunity that Dario Cueto speaks about is something that is very important to every luchador here.
You said that we've seen everything they have, but every time that this kid steps in the ring, he always has one new move. So maybe tonight might be something special. As I said, you gotta dig into that bag of tricks.
Yeah, Lucha Underground, the evolution of wrestling and Lucha Libre all around the world.
And his opponent, from the inframundo, Drago!
I've made no bones about the fact that this young man is my favorite luchador here in Lucha Underground. I will try to stay impartial, but there is a part of me that is pulling for that man, Drago.
I would say that he's my favorite for this match. He's darker, he's dirtier. And to dig down into that black bag in it, as we call it, in his soul, maybe there's something there that we haven't seen yet.
Ring the bell!
He's too well matched. We've seen it now. This is the fifth match in an epic series. Drago on the move. Aerostar stops him with a kick to the gut. Aerostar now looks like he's hooking up for a suplex. Drago blocks it. Still very early in the match. Punches to the kidney now, trying to soften Drago up. Drago in the blue. Aerostar in the silver or white. Call it what you will. Oh! Drago shows that he has the strength advantage there. That was a brain buster. Cover. Referee's down. No, a two count early on. And notice how Drago stays very close and tries to hook in a submission.
He's got it almost like a chokehold on him there. But that suplex was made pretty famous in Mexico when Eddie Guerrero was down there. He used to knock people out with that left, right, and center.
Dario Cueto, our owner. This is the biggest match in both of these luchadors' careers because this unique opportunity that Dario keeps alluding to is very intriguing.
You know, Matt, it is the biggest match in their career, but I'm almost more excited because I want to know what... Dario's kind of freaky, so I want to see what he's promising here.
The unique style we've come to know and love from Aerostar. Billed as he's from the cosmos, perhaps some divine intervention will be in Aerostar's future.
Maybe, but you know what? I hope they don't make the mistake of trying to showboat and not go for the win, man.
Aerostar now hung up in the tree of woe. Boom! Basement drop kick by Drago.
That'll take your head right out of alignment with your back, bro. You know it's gonna swell up the traps quick enough.
The positioning of Aerostar, notice how Drago brings Aerostar back to the middle of the ring. That's where you wanna go for your pinfalls or your submissions, away from the ropes.
Ooh. Oh my God.
Drago now senses it. No.
This is the first time since we have been here that I have seen our owner, ringside, paying so much attention. Uh-oh, here we go.
Both men on the move now. Oh, double clothesline, send both luchadores down. Notice Drago fell first. Now both men's shoulders flat on the mat. We talk about it all the time. Whoever stirs, whoever gets up first, enjoys the advantage.
Aerostar's knocked out, but he rolled over. Rolled over with his face down so his back wouldn't be planted. Maybe he wouldn't get that count. That's a big sign of experience right there.
You can see Dario Cueto grinding his teeth, his jaw moving back and forth. Could it be the tension? Could it be the anxiety? Could it be something else?
Ooh, that was snug. Very snug. Uh-oh. Eye for an eye, brother. We said it. Every action has a reaction.
Aerostar with the trust fall sends Drago down. While I'm sure a count-out victory would mean something to these luchadores, that's not the way that they want to win this match. That's not the way our owner wants to see it done.
No doubt about it, brother.
And the referee not counting, just urging the luchadores to get back in the ring. With his boss within earshot, Lefty Borden doesn't want to lose his job.
Matt, you do not want to fight a battle that has lasted this long and has so many casualties in your psyche to just win by a count-out.
And everyone knows that the longer wars go on, no matter who wins or loses, there's always going to be ramifications and detrimental effects of long-term fighting. Drago now trying to get as far away from his opponent, Aerostar, as possible. Aerostar, perhaps with a lower back injury, still on the move, though, there.
They've got weeks of injuries piling up, brother. They've beat each other up for a long time here, Matt.
Normally, you see these two enjoy a much quicker pace, but because of the collateral damage and because of this high stakes, you can see the pace far more methodical.
Methodical, yes, and a lot more aggressive with a lot more intent to win like this one. We got one, two.
That nanosecond there, that Aerostar's shoulder was not all the way down. Our referee did a great job there. That could have been the difference.
Fans are feeling it. Something's coming. They're starting to go for the kill.
I agree, Vamp. These two luchadors have given it their all in this series, and unfortunately, only one can win.
Watch out, watch out, watch out. Recoup, recoup. Oh, jeez.
Wow.
Brother, what was that?
Aerostar in for the cover, referee is down. Unique opportunity on the line. No, the match continues.
God, brother. So, it's gonna hurt to see a loser.
Ooh.
Go for the pin, go for the pin. Man, I don't know.
Respect
for
his opponent.
I don't know.
Cover by Aerostar, two, no. And Vamp, we're seeing that Aerostar is using the distance between himself and his opponent to his advantage, whereas Drago can't seem to make up that distance. It's a timing issue. It's a space issue for Drago.
Is it? Maybe he doesn't want to be too high risk today. Maybe he's trying to injure and set up for the kill. Maybe he's hunting.
Ooh, big clothesline. And again, it doesn't take a fancy move. No, not enough. You can win a match with a hip toss, you can win a match with a shooting star press. In the record books, it just says you won. And now, Drago's frustration seemed to be taking over, tugging at the mask. We've discussed how sacred the masks are here in Lucha Libre.
These guys have definitely found ways to come out, pull victories out throughout this whole series. So this is gonna go down to something we haven't seen yet.
Well, we've talked about adjustments and great coaches in all sports. Adjustments need to be made as your opponents begin to learn your playbook and vice versa.
Good God, this is like the final battle, man. This is just physically demanding, spiritually demanding, biting a part out of your heart, man. This is, it's gonna be a shame to see it end.
And when this series started, we saw the friendship and the respect, and all of that is out the window.
What did I tell you, man? He is gonna dig down into the darkness. This is
it always amazes me, the things that are underneath the wrestling ring.
Yeah, it's like the closet, right?
You would know.
Look at Dario Cueto smiling. He know he put that under there. Who's he kidding? Dario's crazy, man. The more violent it is, the more happy, the more I see him smile.
Important to point out, no disqualifications and no countouts as per our owner, Dario Cueto.
Dario's right there, front row, man. He's feeling it. The fans are crazy. They're calling for blood, dude. You heard the cartilage getting busted open in his neck there from them forearms. Chris Adams told me, you put that elbow around the ear, you're gonna knock some brain cells loose.
Oh, Aerostar able to get off of the table and out of harm's way. And now the irony, Drago set up on the table that Drago introduced into the match.
Uh-oh, the fans know.
Aerostar will fly, holy shiz!
That's it, that is what I want to see, yes!
Well, the faithful seem firmly behind Aerostar. Ooh, nice. Could this be Aerostar's opportunity? No.
He didn't have it hooked in deep enough, Matt. He's got the right idea. He's just not got the right technique at this stage.
You can tell by the way Aerostar is moving, he's having trouble breathing.
You think he's out of gas? What I mean by that is, do you think he's ran out of tricks? He just can't seem to finish off Drago?
Oh, but perhaps going through that table had something to do with it.
Like a soccer game that I've seen in Latin America many, many times, the fans have taken sides, almost like hooligan skinheads in London, England. The fans are chanting, let's go Aerostar, let's go Drago.
And I said that the faithful were fronting behind Aerostar. I correct myself, the faithful equally divided here. Roll through, victory roll, is this enough?
Whoa. No!
Aerostar right back up, inside cradle, small package, can he hook both legs? No! You'll notice that Aerostar constantly going for victories, constantly going for pinfalls. Aerostar on the move now, Drago up, went for the backdrop, sunset flip, but Drago had the momentum into the basement dropkick.
Matt, you said it earlier, you can win with a shooting star press or you can do a schoolboy. This is, we're down to the wire here, man. Who's got the most heart and who's got the most resiliency left in their bodies?
Whatever sport you're into, if it's extra time and then soccer, football, if it's overtime, if it's the bottom of the ninth, whatever it is that you're into, you can understand the importance of these two in their fifth match of a best of five series.
Wow, elbows to the jaw. Ooh. Wow, not something right out of Drago.
Who will have the walk-off hit? Who will be the hero?
Ooh, brother, this is war.
Oh, beautifully done. Signature move by Drago, but notice where Aerostar is. Right on the ropes, not in the middle of the ring.
Exactly, but he is knocked out. We've seen this in boxing or MMA millions of times. When you're knocked out, it's almost near the end, bro.
Drago barely gets to his feet. We've seen this before.
Whoa.
The Dragon's Lair, the Tale of the Dragon 2. Drago wins! Drago wins! Drago wins! After a huge career-defining series, Drago comes back after being down and finally wins the fifth match in the best of five series. And now the unique opportunity from our owner is the prize that we're all waiting for.
Aerostar gave it his all, brother. He gave it his all. He gave it his heart and soul, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. But it wasn't enough. I've been waiting for this for months, like you have, Matt.
And the respect of these two luchadors has been the subplot. And after you go through war with someone, you have to respect what they can give you. And this is what Drago is showing. This is the honor and pride of Lucha Libre, the honor and pride of Mexico, and it deserves an ovation, damn it. Back there, some good lucha, folks.
Under those masks, those are men with honor. A lot of humanity, a lot of character being shown here. Kids at home wanting to get into this business, pay attention to what you're seeing here. It's not about the victory.
Right now, it's about Dario Cueto's unique opportunity. And that's not just a buzzword. Dario Cueto has been a man of his word since Lucha Underground debuted.
Drago, you've impressed El Jefe very much. So, for this unique opportunity, I'm gonna give you the biggest prize I can offer. A shot against Prince Puma for the Lucha Underground Championship. But there is one little catch. If you don't win the Lucha Underground Championship, you will be banned from my temple forever!
Well, here in Lucha Underground, where victories earn you opportunities, Dario Cueto has put his little spin on it. You heard it from the owner, and now Drago is torn. The greatest opportunity in his career to become Lucha Underground champion. But Dario said, if Drago fails, we will never see Drago again here in the temple.